Hello students, welcome to Virtual Training Center Dada. I am Mrs. Akshata Kale and today we are going to learn English of Standard 5th and today's topic is the grammar part, that is nouns. Okay, yes students, here you can see so many pictures, right? And each picture is identified by its name, isn't it? Okay, today we will learn about the names of persons, things, place, etc., which comes under the heading of nouns. Okay, now we will learn about the meaning and types of nouns with the help of examples. Now first we will understand the meaning of the noun. So what is a noun? A noun is a word used to name a person, animal, place, thing, and abstract idea. Okay, now here see, the girl Chitra, the boy Suresh, and here only girls are shown. Okay, these means here the name of a person or a name of a persons. Now here we can see house, school, names of a place. Okay, and here an apple, tree, names of a things. Then here you can see here the emojis showing different feelings. Here up it is happy feeling and the second one is sad. So these are abstract ideas or feelings. Yes students, all these come under nouns. Got this? And the name of the animals also comes under nouns. We will study them separately. The names given to particular persons or places are known as proper nouns. Remember, a particular person's name or a place. Okay. See, this is called proper noun. See, this is Santa Claus, is a proper noun. Titanic, the name of that ship. Okay, here this is our earth, our planet. The name of our planet is earth, so it is a proper noun. See, two children, Mona and Sahil, this is also a proper noun. And Mumbai, our city, correct? Now, this is a particular name for our city, so it is a proper noun. India, our country. Yeah, river Ganga. There are so many rivers, but this river is a Ganga river, so it is a proper noun. Sun, our star. Okay, this is also a proper noun. Again, I want to tell you that proper nouns means a specific names. Okay, individual names are called as proper nouns. Maybe of persons or maybe of places. Okay. A common noun names any person, place, thing or idea. Your proper noun means specific name, but your common noun means commonly used names. See, example, elephant, mango, street, butterfly, caterpillar, car, hat, dog, girl, cat. See, these all names are used commonly. Correct? So they are called as common nouns. Okay? Remember, a common noun names any person, place, thing, or idea. Common nouns are not capitalized. Remember, they are not capitalized means we will not use capital letters for these nouns unless they come at the beginning of a sentence. But in the proper noun names a particular person. Okay, for example, your name is Rahul. Then Rahul is a proper noun. And you are a boy. Boy is a common noun. For this, if Neha is your name, Neha is a proper noun and girl is a common noun. Got this? Okay. And one more thing is that proper nouns are always capitalized. Means whenever we write the name of a person or a place which is particular or specific, then we use capital letter. Then we use capital letter in the beginning of that word. Got this? Remember this difference, okay? Now, abstract nouns. Abstract nouns means they show us the feelings or ideas. Okay, we will see some of the examples. See here, bravery. Correct? Friendship. Childhood. Anger. See this feeling. Favorite. Like this, they are called as abstract nouns which give us an idea or a feelings. Happiness, sadness, all these comes under abstract nouns. Now, dear students, we studied about proper noun, common nouns and abstract nouns. Now here, some nouns refer to something that can be counted. They are countable nouns. Counted means here we can count them. So many pens are there, 10 pens are there, one bird is there, like this. Then they are called as countable nouns. Example, see here, three eggs. Correct? Here so many seeds are there on the watermelon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 seeds are there on the watermelon. So it is a countable. Here, tomatoes. 5 tomatoes are there. And here, French fries. See, we can count them, isn't it? So it is a countable noun. Here you can see burgers, sandwiches, and hot dogs. They also come under countable nouns because we order, we need 10 burgers, we need 20 burgers, correct? So they come under countable nouns. Now your carrots, 2 carrots, 1 apple, 2 olives, correct? See, this is called as countable nouns. Again, I will tell you that whichever is can be counted, that is called countable noun. Okay. Now here, uncountable nouns, the opposite of countable nouns. See here, some nouns refer to something that cannot be counted. They are uncountable nouns. Example, rain. We can't count the rain. Soap. Coffee, honey, jam, butter, sugar, snow, flour, rice. Got the students? These materials we can't count. So they come under uncountable nouns. Very easy it is. Only thing is you have to understand the difference between the countable and uncountable nouns. Okay. So I have taken so many examples to make the concept clear. Countable noun has two forms. Countable means we can count, correct? Okay, there has two forms. First one, singular, means when it refers to one thing. If one is there, then it is a singular. And many are there, then it is a plural, isn't it? So, here, we will go through the examples. See here, one child and many children. Correct? Countable noun has two forms here. One child is a singular and plural of that is children. One butterfly, many butterflies. One glass and many glasses. One rose, many roses. One cat and many cats. Got the students? Find the type of noun. Okay, we will see first the pictures. Okay, here six pictures are there. You have to write which type of noun is it. Okay, first one, the cat is sitting and it is telling what? My name is Ruby. Means it has a specific name, that is Ruby. So this is a, yes, correct, that is a proper noun. Second one, the bird. Yes, I am a bird. Then, is this a proper or common? Yes, correct. This is a common noun. Next, see this one, emoji. Very angry here. So, this is a abstract noun. Isn't it? It is showing the feeling. Next one, sweets are there. We can count them. So we can write here, countable noun. And here, glass of milk is there. We can't count it. So it is uncountable noun. Yes, dear students, a chair is there. Chair is a common name. So it is a common noun. Okay, like this we have to classify the given pictures under the headings of different types of nouns. Okay. Yes, thank you students. Yes, please list out some of common nouns, some proper nouns, some abstract nouns. Okay. Take care of yourself and stay safe. Bye-bye.